to bring a word of encouragement to you today, and I'm taking the word from the book of John, chapter 16 and verse 33, and I read from the NIV, and it says, I've told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have trouble, but take heart or be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. The word of Jesus. So Jesus and the disciples have been together for a while, and he's about to leave them and to go. And as I share this, I can identify with this particular experience, because as a pastor, as other pastors, we serve in districts for a number of years, and then you have new administrations coming in, and usually when they come in, they tend to realign the districts and reassign pastors. And then all of a sudden you get a letter saying, a pastor, you've been moved to a new district. And in one of my districts where I served, one of my churches, and it depends on how good the church is or how bad it is, because in some churches it's good, in some it's bad. But this one, this experience was good for me, and it was time to move on to a different district, and the church organized a send-off, and they got some presents for me. And during this time of separation, it was very, very emotional, and we were all weeping, including myself. I never expected it to be this way, but that's what it was. Very emotional. So Jesus also, the disciples, is about to leave, and he has been with them for this period of time. And it is emotional. They're despondent. They're discouraged because Christ is about to leave. But then Jesus says to them in John 16:33, he said, I've said these things to you so that in me you may have peace. In other words, I'm going away. In John chapter 14, he's promised that he will come back again. He says, I'm coming back again. But whilst you're waiting for my return in this world, he says, you will have troubles. You will have tribulations. He didn't say you may have tribulations. He didn't say you might have trouble. He didn't say you could have trouble. He said definitely. He said you will have troubles. I'm not a prophet of doom. I'm not a preacher of doom, brothers and sisters, sons of God. These are not my words. These are not your words, but these are the words of God, and the words of God are true. And Jesus says that we are going to have troubles whilst we wait for his return. And right now, we're experiencing trouble. We are in crisis. The world is in crisis because of COVID-19. The world is in turbulence. The world is in trouble. The words of God are true. In Matthew chapter 24 and verses 6 to 8, Jesus gave the prophecy. He says that there will be wars and rumors of wars. Kingdoms will rise against kingdom. There will be earthquakes in diverse places, pestilences and famines. All these things are troublesome things. All these things are difficult and trying times, but these are the words of God that they have to come to pass because Jesus has prophesied them. In the end of that particular section in Matthew 24, he says, these are only the beginning of sorrows. The beginning of sorrows. In other words, difficult days are ahead. Sins of God. Well, Christ is saying that we need to tighten our seatbelts. We need to brace ourselves. Just like the pilot would tell you when you're about to go through turbulence, he says, tighten your seatbelts, make sure the seat is up, because we're going to go through turbulence. Christ is saying that we are going to go through turbulence. We're going through it now with COVID-19 and the many days ahead that these things are going to come. We've gone through the Spanish flu. We've gone through Ebola. We've gone through the AIDS epidemic. We're going through COVID-19. We've gone through SARS, pestilence, earthquakes, wars. Diverse places are going to happen. The world in which we live, saints of God, is a broken world. The world in which we live is a sinful world. Sin is present. Evil is present. The devil is here. This world is a broken world. These things are going to happen. Troubles are going to come. Trials are going to come. These things come because the word of God has revealed, but they've come also to try our faith. They've come also to strengthen our faith. Because as these things happen, we can say, yes, the word of God is true. But we can draw nearer to God. How do we know we have faith? How do we know our faith is anchored in God? How do we know our faith is strong? When it is not tried, it's not tested, we've not gone through this trying time. The world in which you live is broken, but there's a better world coming. So whilst we wait for Christ, we're going to go through crisis. We're going through this crisis now. The crisis is a pandemic. It's affecting the entire world. People are losing their jobs. People are going mental. People are committing suicide. People cannot pay their bills. People are thinking about where they're going to get the next job from. Frontline workers are losing their lives. Vulnerable. Trying to save lives, losing their lives. We all are vulnerable. We all are going through this crisis. Because Jesus said they're going to happen. And his words have come to pass. The crisis is causing different problems. But after Jesus said this to the disciples, they're going to go through trials, they're going to go through troubles. He said in the same John 16 verse 33, he says, but I've said these things to you that in me you may have peace. So while we're going through the crisis, we can look to the Prince of Peace. We can look to Jehovah, our protector, our shield, the one who can never fail us. He says, in me, if you trust in me, in the midst of the crisis, if you put your faith in me, if you put your anchor in me, if you lay all your eggs in this basket, you will have peace. Because you'll be assured that God is going to take care. You see, peace is not just the absence of weapons of war, the absence of conflicts, the absence of trouble, but peace is being calm and assured in the midst of the crisis, in the midst of the storm. Just like Jesus lying down in our boat on the Sea of Galilee when the storm was raging, he was asleep. The disciples were panicking and running helter-skelter, but Jesus was asleep because he was at peace. Because he is the Prince of Peace. So he says that as we go through the storm, as we go through the water and the fire, as we go through the crisis, we can have peace in the midst of that storm. We can be calm and assured that he's going to take us through. This is what peace is. The crisis does not trouble us, but the crisis helps us to put our faith and our trust in Christ. And if we can have that trust in him, we will have peace. We can smile at the storm because there is a silver lining behind this, that weeping may endure for a night, but indeed joy comes in the morning. The morning may be literally the next morning. The morning may be the morning when Jesus comes again, finally, to bring everything to an end. So as we go through turbulence, as we go through crisis, as we go through trying times, let us put our faith in Christ. Because indeed, he has overcome. He says to us, I have already overcome all these things. So put your faith in me. Let us put our faith in Christ today as we go through the crisis. And he will see us through. Continue to trust him. Even if he calls us to sleep in death, there's a better day coming. Let us trust him because he has overcome the world. God bless you.